don't call me.
Today I'm going to be telling you guys how I film and edit my Instagram photos. So I'm going to start. Oh, I was supposed to tell y'all. So basically what I used to take all my pictures, like 90% of my pictures I take with my phone, even though I have a camera. But I got the iPhone 8 or whatever. So most of my pictures I do take on my iPhone because it got a nice camera or whatever. But some pictures I do take on my camera. Right now I have the Nikon Coolpix 500 or something like that. I'll put a picture of it. But I used to have the Sony. I can't even remember what it was called. But it was a Sony camera. But I just got a new camera, which is a Nikon camera. So first off, if you haven't followed me on Instagram, follow me on Instagram at _destiny. And I really just started editing my picture. This one of the pictures that I edited. Then we got this one, or these ones. This one is my favorite pictures. I'm gonna tell y'all how I did this one and how I did this one. Okay, so basically how I edit my pictures, I use this app called Facetune, and then I use PhotoGrid too. I notice people be using like a lot of different types of apps when I be watching other people's videos on YouTube about how they edit their photos, and they be using a lot of different types of apps. I don't do all that. I really just do Facetune. So the first picture I'm gonna show y'all is going to be this one. First, I want to show y'all the difference of the picture, how I edited it, how I edited the picture. I'm gonna show y'all how it was when I first took the picture, and then how it was afterwards. So this is when I first took it. As you can see, like my makeup was kinda all over the place. It's my closure. You can see it a little bit. The it was keeping like background noise type. And now I have got it to be like this. So now flawless everything, because sometimes I make up that these too many things to do, especially when it be on all day and it starts to wear off and stuff like that. And then I got this picture I'm gonna show y'all. This is how it was when I first started. And I typed it into this. And what else? I think that's all. I'm sorry I did. So I'm gonna start with the first one. I'm gonna go into my Facetune app. I'm going to try to edit the picture just how I did the first time, but it was a while ago, so I might not get all of it. Look at this picture. Alright, so when we in there, now, first thing I do automatically, a lot of people too, when I be watching people videos on Facetune, they be saying don't really go in with the smooth app, but I be going in with the smooth app because, I don't know. They be saying it be making you look cartoony, but it's just how you use it. You can't just be putting it on you, you know what I'm saying? But right now, I'm whitening my eyeballs, because my eyes is kind of red in this picture. And I'm going to go to the smooth tool, and I'm going to just smoothen out all the areas where my makeup not looking its best. Need a little work. I'm re-beating my face down there. And then you can see the difference already, just if you do like that. Then I'm going to go in with the details tool. And I'm basically anything that I want to pop. So I just went in on my highlight, on my nose, over my eyeballs, my eyebrows. I'm going to go over my hair with the details tool. And then I'm going to go in with the smoother on the details tool. So it'll make it, it just, I don't know, I just like it like that. And I'm gonna go over my jacket, purse, phone case. Just a little stuff in the picture that you wanna pop. Now since the background is kinda dull and whatnot, I'm going to go over the background with my little glow tool to get a background, like more of a little, a defined little definition or whatever. And then I'm gonna go over it with the vibrance tool as well, just to make the background more like pop out more, because it was kind of, you know, dark and dingy at the restaurant. eraser and go over my body, so my body don't have stuff on it that I don't want. Okay, now with the face tool, you could do this if you want. I really don't be doing this like that, but I think on this one I did make my jawline a little smaller and the width. Nothing too serious though. You don't want to make it too serious. Now I'm gonna go in with the filters, and I always like my favorite filter is no, I always go to no filter, and then number 3 is my favorite one. I'm just take this one down a little bit. Alright. Now for the dress. For this one, usually I do it different, but for this one I took the brightness up. And I remember I took the contrast down because it made my hair just look. I just like the way it made my hair look. And then I took the color up and I sharpened it just a tad. So yeah, that's basically how it was. And then I went in with the light FX tool. A lot of people don't use this, but I don't like it. I think I did it like right here. And then I faded it out a little bit. I mean, it's just like a whole different picture. Like, it's just popping now. And before it was popping, but it wasn't that popping. But now it's flawless. Okay, now, actually, I think that's all. I think that's all I did for this. Yeah, that's basically it. Let me see. No, yeah, that's gonna be it for this. Now I'm gonna show y'all how I did this one. So like I said, first you gotta go in and crop it, cause I just took a screenshot of it and I got the live thing and whatever. Alright, so boom. So on this one, you don't really need a lot to the face because my makeup was fresh this time, but I'm still just going with the smoothing tool just a little bit, just to smooth out some of the areas that wasn't as smooth as it could be. Whitened, going to eyeballs, make them pop a little more. Oh, I remember on this picture, I had one in and just OD'd on the snow. Because the snow, in the photo shoot that we had, the snow was a little dirty downtown. Because we live in Michigan, it was just dirty. So I just went in with the whitening tool like crazy. But don't. Be careful, don't be getting it all over there. I really like went crazy with the white. And to make it more white, I had went in with the matte tool and matted it a little bit. A little more white. And boom, you can already see the difference. Like, but back then it just looked just so dingy. Now I just look fresh. Now I'm gonna go in with the details tool. Boom. Highlight, eyes, eyebrows. I'm gonna do it on the graffiti. And this is such a big difference. Okay, I'm going with the glow on the graffiti too. And with the vibrance. Just make the graffiti look a little more shuffling. I don't know if I need the vibrance on this one. Nah, just like that. Okay, now we're gonna start my favorite. I ain't gonna do the face one on this one because that's just going too much. My leg is killing me. Okay, now we're gonna go in with the filters and we're gonna go to no filter 3. My fade to turn down a little bit because that one do make me look a little fake on this picture. Boom. I'm gonna go in with the brightness. We're gonna turn the brightness up. We're gonna turn the contrast up this time instead of down. Color. We don't really need to sharpen it just a little bit. And then I remember. Boom. And that's just popping. Like, that's just so cute. So, I'm going to show y'all, I'm going to use this one. So, this picture was taken on my, I think I had a 6 at the time, iPhone 6 at this time. So, I'm going to just go in and act as if I was editing this. So, my makeup was pretty fresh or whatever. So, you really don't need much of this. Details, once again, I'm going with my jacket. And the car. Does the car match the jacket? for y'all. I'm gonna do a little glow on the car just to make my car look more. You feel me? Vibrance. This is my first time editing this picture, y'all. So you see the difference to make my car look like super like shiny, like it just had a car wash when it really didn't. Filters, let's see. I swear, no filter number 3, Bass Tune 2 is where it's at. Yeah, and then I'm gonna go in with. I'm gonna make it a little. Sorry, this is my first time editing this picture, so. I know I wanted to come here so I could sharpen the picture because this picture was taken on my iPhone and not my camera. So it was kind of, you know, a little on the blurry side. So I want to show y'all how to defocus the picture so it can look like you took it on the camera, but you really didn't. Like, you know how when you take a picture with that camera, it got like the blurry background effect. And we just gonna do a part. But when we do it, we're gonna turn it all the way up so it just make it so much like easier to see. If you're defocusing the right part or not. So I'm just going real sloppy at first. Just everywhere that needs to be. And then I'm going to go in and clean it up with the eraser tool. And we're not going to leave it like this because this looks a mess, but you know. Try to get in them little spaces that I couldn't get in. Okay, I am not sure what part that my camera just cut off on. I'm sorry, y'all gonna have to bear with me. I'm still learning how to use this camera because I just got it. So whatever part it cut off on, I'll make up for it somehow, somewhere. But if you like this video, don't like this video, comment, like, subscribe, share, post notifications. And don't forget to subscribe. But I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.